Alrighty, here's video number two of the Polar Lights NX-01, 1/350th NX-01 build. Pretty much, as I see, everything on the last video pretty much covered except for fiber optics. Let me show you where I got the fiber optics at. This is the way they come, little strands, the way I buy them anyway. Here's the guy that I get them from, the fiberopticstore.com, all one word. Really fast shipper and does a really nice job, has good prices too, so... get all the fiber optics I need. I wasn't really sure what sizes I needed, so I just got a little bit of everything. I mean, they're so cheap, so I'm going to use them for another project too. I've got a Millennium Falcon I'm going to do next winter, which is definitely going to be fiber optic intense. But anyway, the glass, I don't know if I covered this in the last video or not, but everything, the glass is frosted with dull coat. This was brushed with a little bit of white frost window spray. Just to make sure that it's very opaque and you can't really see inside. All you can see is the glow of the light. And I did everything for the windows here. I'm going to basically, the assembly is I'm going to build the kit up completely and then mask off and paint it, which is kind of in the face of the conventional wisdom of painting it and then building it. But hopefully, you know, I've got a lot of experience masking those windows off, and they actually did really good on the refit. I don't see why they'd be any different here. Let's see if I get that in focus. I think they're going to look really good. And really, the window, the saucer is the only place you've got. Now what there is a trick on these things is the warp engines. Here's what I'm working on right here. In fact, I'll show you what I've done with the engines. This is basically a multi-step process to get these right. And everything that's blue was white, was black. I'll cover it in a second. The engines, it's kind of weird, but here's how they're supposed to, well, this isn't exactly how they're supposed to look, but here's the basic premise. Not everyone, most people leave them clear. Actually, this is not how they're supposed to look. I think they're supposed to be silver if you go by the screen correct look. And this is kind of why I said about making things my own. I think this looks a lot better having that contrast in here. But when this gets lit up, you're going to see how cool that's going to look. So what I've done is I masked off those sections with custom cut tape. I measured out the tape strips and cut it, laid it in place, and that's really the only thing that stayed clear is where you see the shiny blue spots. I then painted about 3 or 4 coats of black paint on it for the light blocking. I put a couple of coats of white on it for the light diffusion, and then I went back and sprayed some clear blue or transparent blue, about 2 or 3 coats of transparent blue on them. Just give them a blue look while the engines are off. Now, as far as the other side, I'm going to mask these, and you can see I haven't had this out dry fitting it. It's black in there, looks nice, but it's shiny and it's clear and it's a little translucent because it's picking up some light from the edges, and it's, you can see right here how it's picking up the light from the edges, and right there on the edges it's showing it through the plastic. So what I'm going to do is I've masked these off and I'm going to very lightly dust in some flat black. Now, according to Doug Drexler's pictures, this is really supposed to be silver, basically the same color as the hull. And I kind of like the contrast that's in here. You see how it's kind of black, you know, where it's going to be flat black. That's going to be a really nice contrast. And if I had that silver, this is kind of about the way I am about making things my own. I like to make models a little different. I go with what looks best in my view rather than what's scale. I mean, really, this thing never existed, so what is scale? It's based on imagination, so it's up for... I'm going to try to put this in here so you can see how cool. Well, you'll get the idea. It's going to have one of these pipes running down each side anyway, so you're not really going to see a whole lot of anything. Now, with the light kit on, let me see if I can just set this camera right here. This is kind of unconventional, but I want you to see how good this looks. How good is that going to look? Now, on this side right here, I think I'm going to put some frost in behind here as a final step because I want these to be diffused a little bit. However, on this piece, I've done the same steps. There is something I need to tell you on this. A lot of people miss this, but I'll tell you in just a second. This is going to have some hot spots in it. You can see how good that's going to look. And I kind of like the hot spots. I'm not going to diffuse this, especially it's going to have that pipe running down the center of it, so the actual bulb you will not see, you'll just see the glow around it, and that's going to look really nice. The camera may be washing it out, but there's very pronounced hot spots on the lens itself, and I think that's going to look really good on the inboard nacelles. Now on this thing right here, notice how I'm going to try to zoom in on this as best I can without losing focus. Notice how the detail of the grid goes all the way out to the edge. Well, here's the thing. When you go paint this thing, there's nowhere to mask it. So what you're going to have to do is, I made this mistake. I masked it off, and then once I got everything off and everything cleared, I looked at it, and it was dark. It was black right here on the edge, which really the little pipe that comes in here covers most of that up. It kind of plucks right in here and covers just about all that up, but still there's some grill. And the same on this side, just not as bad. Now the reason being is because the plastic gets very thick right here for the way it's molded. So what you have to do is go back and scrape, or just mask this off too. Mask it all the way off to this line and then paint it. A lot of people miss that I've seen. And this way, when now you see it really bad right here, but once the light gets on it, it pretty much all but disappears. There we go. Well, actually, that's probably showing it. There we go. That's what it's going to look like, more or less. And with the pipe there, how am I going to get that in focus? You're really not even going to see that much. So that's really no way around that. But you know, like I said, the pipe's going to cover most of that up. At least you get that blue all the way to the edge like it's supposed to be, instead of having like a, see if I can get it to show up again, the dark spot like this. Also, what I've done is I've went back and painted this with a little bit of aluminum mixed with flat black, just to give it a dark steel color, and that's gonna make it a little bit darker than the hull, but not black. Just a little contrast always looks good on these things. And finally, I will show you my decals that I've got. Here they are. This is the Aztec decals that come from, I guess, Acreation. I don't know how you pronounce this. Acreation. Very cool looking, though. And everyone says they apply really well. So I'm looking forward to what those will look like. I actually had a thought about painting this thing white, like the refit, but I decided against it. I think I'm going to go with the silver color, just because it kind of gives it a little bit more menacing industrial look to it. It looks really good. So anyway, that's where we're at. Hopefully have this thing buttoned up and ready to paint in the next couple of weeks. Running those fiber optic cables in these engine rooms and all the light kits is going to be tough. So I've got a lot of figuring out. I'm kind of building by the seat of my pants, and the instruction book's out the window. So hopefully we'll get everything together and won't forget anything before I get it buttoned up and ready to paint. And as you noticed, I am using a new camera. Got a new Olympus pen, so a lot better high definition video. So anyway, let me show you what I've done to my refit in the downtime. Alrighty, here we are with the update on my 1/350th refit. And as you can see, I've made a couple of little changes to my base that I've had. What really pushed me to do this, I saw some awesome videos on YouTube about people that's done some great jobs on the refits. They just look fantastic, and even better jobs on their bases. You know, they've got these custom-made bases with the panels in them and everything. Now, kind of made me think that maybe I need to do something on this one. Now, I didn't want to go over to the extreme. You know, it's all personal taste, but I think, you know, if you put all these panels in here with the backlight and even some people have, you know, video camera or video screens, it kind of takes away from the model. I didn't want to, in my opinion, it takes away from the model. I didn't want anything to take away from the model. That's the centerpiece. The base is there to support it, but I did think it needed a little something there just to make it look like it belongs under a Starfleet model or a Starfleet ship. So here's what we've done. This is the plastic I've cut out in the shape of a Starfleet emblem, just transferred it over. It's real easy to make, actually. I painted the plastic a dark silver, or a very flat finish, metallic silver, but not, it's more of a light charcoal gray, actually. And I cut another piece out of the same plastic and painted it flat black and put on top just to give it some relief. You can't see it here, but it looks really good. It's just a nice nice, very well done emblem. Everything's sanded down smooth. The backlight, of course, is with the 12-volt strip LEDs. However, you don't have to run 12 volts to them. I've got 9 volts running to them, which is actually better because it gives it a nice soft glow. Enough to be noticed, but not enough to really take away your attention from this. It all runs on the same power supply as the truck modeler ship. It's all run on one single power supply, so it's very easy to do. Just had to drill a hole in here to run my wires, and really looks really nice. Anyway, here's the other thing I've done on my ship, which is the deflector dish. And as you can see here, we got the blue. However, the yellow, I never did like the way the yellow looked. It wasn't screen correct. Well, you put a little coat of transparent red on it, and now it's screen correct. What a difference that made. And man, that does look good. Doesn't really go out and grab you, and just makes it look like you got so many different colors. I don't know why I don't keep that in focus on the ship. But yeah, it turned out really nice. And you know, I've had this model done for a year and a half now. I've taken it to several model shows. Done really good at them. I've won first place, and I've won best of show. Here's the trophy for best of show of the first one I took it to. So done really nice, and the light kit has been flawless. It's definitely the way to go. I hadn't had any problems out of it, and like I said, I've run this thing for hours on. I mean, I run this thing at one model show for probably 8 hours straight, no problems at all. So doesn't get put cut on any much anymore, but it's nice to know that I've got something in there that's going to last. So anyway, that's the update on my Enterprise, and we'll see you in a couple of weeks with the update on my 1/350th NX-01.